Welcome back to KC Talks EV. Now I'm here with probably one of the biggest legends of the Nissan Leaf Owners Club UK. I'm here with Paul Eden.
Bless you for saying so, Kevin.
So I guess first of all, start off with, I mean, what got you into EVs in the first place?
Well, in 2013, I was between cars, and I need to be a bit careful here because my wife is sitting over there and I didn't tell her that I borrowed a 24 kilowatt Leaf from the local dealer. And I ran it for a couple of days. Absolutely loved it. Hid it. I parked it away from the house. Marie doesn't know. She knows now because I've mentioned this before. I ran it for 2 days. The battery was nearly flat. I rang Nissan and I said, I'm done with it. Very nice. Thank you. I didn't buy one at the time. Fast forward 5 years. I sold the HRV that I did buy. 18 months ago, I bought a 2016 Nissan Leaf in Sonic Blue, 30 kilowatt. The short answer to your question is, I've been into it for some time, but actually only an owner for the last 18 months to 2 years.
Oh, excellent. Well, in that case then, I mean, you're kind of new to obviously the EV, but I'm guessing you knew a lot more about it before you purchased it, I'm guessing.
I had certainly decided back in 2013 that I was going to buy a Leaf. It was just a matter of time.
Initially, I actually went to go test drive a Leaf 30, you see, and I loved it. Honestly, this was back in 2018, I think it was. And when I first test drove it, honestly, loved it to bits. I drove it around for about...
Was it the Gen 1 or the Gen 2?
It would have been the Gen 1 30 kilowatt hour. So the old shape, not the newer one, obviously, not the 40 or the 62.
Yeah, because they changed model in 2018.
Yes, absolutely. Do you still call it a facelift or is it, I don't know.
We in the community and Nissan call them Gen 1 and Gen 2. It was a facelift, yes. However. The chassis and the interior, most of the interior are exactly the same.
But yeah, I guess to kind of also sort of go on from this, I mean, what do you use your Nissan Leaf for?
Mine's purely for commuting.
Okay, right.
It gets me from home in the Chilterns to Greenford in West London. It's about 17 miles out. The family car is, we've just bought a used MG5 just a few days ago. And so we haven't really tested the family in it, but yeah, that's our family car, and the Nissan Leaf is commuting for me.
Absolutely. So essentially, I mean, how many miles have you put on it in the last 18 months then? I mean, what?
That's a very good question. I don't remember. It's 79,000 now.
Oh, okay. Wow.
So and we're doing about 10,000 a year, so it was probably late 50s, early 60s.
The weirdest thing is that when I've been speaking to some people about Nissan Leaf, they've actually told me not to buy one.
Oh, a lot of people say that.
But the thing is, and you actually come across some of the comments that have, because I actually posted it on my YouTube channel and said, look, I really want to buy a used Leaf, because at the moment, depreciation's a bit all over the place with EVs. And if I'm honest, it just means you get a cheaper car, right?
Yes, precisely. Yeah.
So, but you've actually kind of given me some top tips and things like that about purchasing a used Leaf. I mean, what kind of tips can you give sort of the viewers and everything?
Well, Nissan is unusual in that you can peer very, very deeply into the innards via a smartphone app called Leaf Spy. And I'll put some shots up that explain the detail that you can get from Leaf Spy. So you can very closely examine what's going on in the battery and in the management systems. If you want to, you can get a very good idea of the condition of the car. So first of all, that's the best thing to do. Typically, as with any used car, it's condition, not mileage. And that doesn't apply just to EVs. I mean, get the color you like. I quite fancied a red one. The boss over there said no red cars. We saw this blue one, which was an Ascenter trim, which is the middle trim for generation one Leaf cars. And yeah, I have to say, I've got no real complaints. Test drive it, obviously. There's a few weird things with Leaf. Sometimes the windscreens leak. The top of the suspension turrets on the front, you need to cover them because they get wet. You know, the car's battleship reliable, they really are. There's not a great deal wrong to go with them. As I say, you are able to look inside the car to a much greater extent than you can with some others.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, with the ZSEV, I mean, yeah, you don't get the information you get from Leaf Spy. I mean, I looked at it. You do get battery state of health. On one of the videos I mentioned, I was on 86% state of health after 65K. That's actually not particularly that great, to be honest. I mean,
I've seen some upwards of 95, 100,000 miles. Oh, I haven't looked at our new, we've got a used MG5 at home. Not actually looked under the bonnet, so to speak, yet. But I'm expecting something in north of 90% health. That's uncommon with Leaf. Mm-hmm. I mean, mine's now probably around 60%, 70%. I would usually get a good range of about 80 miles. The 50 miles that I drove here today took about 40% of the battery. Nevertheless, I recharged it so that I can get home.
Yeah.
And at the time, I thought we were going to sit in the car and do a piece, so I wanted to have a relatively full battery. I think Leaf makes a great second car, which is what it is for us. You know, the average drive in this country is 22 miles.
Yeah.
Now, my Leaf can do that twice on a single charge. And if you've got a home charger, you're paying 9 pence a kilowatt. The car does today 4.7 miles per kilowatt.
Wow, okay.
I know, it's extraordinary.
That's really good.
And bear in mind, it's been 7 or 8 degrees. In the summer, I'm doing more than 5.5. It's fantastically efficient.
Well, that's the other thing as well, you see, because you've just mentioned 4.7. Well, I've just driven down here and, okay, I was definitely eco driving, but I really struggled to get it beyond about 4.3, 4.2 yeah. miles per kilowatt hour. So, I mean, yeah, that's absolutely outstanding, that.
Well, the three tricks that I say to my new members, first of all, tyre pressure. Mm-hmm. At least the minimum tyre pressure, 36 PSI is what Nissan Leaf is rated for. You can go 10% above that. Mine are all run at 39. It makes the ride a bit noisy and a bit crashy, if you like. You will definitely reap efficiency benefits. Where the bonnet meets the front wing, it's quite a big gap.
Yeah.
And if you fill that, even if it's just a bit of clear tape, not only do you get a lot of noise reduction, but you get a bit of increase in efficiency. Use B mode. And if you're in really bad traffic, use eco mode. And when I talk to you, you mentioned when I talked to Andy Palmer, Dr. Andy yeah. Palmer, you know, he was extremely proud, and quite rightly so, mm-hmm. of the engineering that's got his name on it. Even now, a 2016 car stands on its own record, I think.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is that the thing that kind of got me interested in this in the first place was I know that the Nissan Leaf's coming to the end of it. Well, it's either come to the end of its production or it has already ended production.
Yeah, no, yeah. They're no longer building it.
Yeah. And the thing is that, as mentioned previously, I mean, I was literally speaking to someone at, I think it was the Octopus Vehicle Stand, I think, and they were saying how the Nissan Leaf was one of the first commercialized full electric passenger vehicles. Mm. So, you know, we have a big history. I mean, it's what now, 12 years, 11, 12 years, I think, from the first
2011, they first came to this country.
Exactly. So, you know, that's 13 years of progress. And the other thing as well is that because the platform hasn't changed that much, but the batteries have changed that much.
Yes.
You've gone from a 24 kilowatt hour to a 62, which I believe was 18 or 19 usable. Now it's gone up to 59.
That's correct.
So, you know, they've learned a lot about batteries. They've learned a lot about buffers. So the fact is that it really has set the stage. And as mentioned, I mean, apart from obviously Tesla as well, Nissan has been really the one that I think a lot of people would have gone for, if a regular people, let's say.
Until 2014, unless you were going to buy something weird like a Mitsubishi Miev,
yeah.
or what's that weird quadricycle? I can't remember. The little tiny one. Unless you're going to buy one of those, the only choice you had was a Nissan Leaf, luckily enough. It's a fantastic car.
And that was the thing. I mean, when I started looking at used pricing for a Nissan Leaf in particular, I just went, well, hang on, I can get one for, well, you've now told me I've got to be a bit careful with this, but when I was looking at around the 3.5 grand, 4 grand mark, that would be, I mean, I used to spend, roughly speaking, about £1,500 in petrol a year.
Mm.
Now, on my off-peak rate, so you mentioned that you're 9.5p, what tariff are you on? Is it?
Octopus Go.
Yeah. Well, Eon's now dropped down to 8p, and
yeah.
obviously, have you got like a Zappy or anything, or an OMI?
No, it's a Hypervolt,
so right.
it doesn't do some of the clever stuff. There's been some announcements on that, and I'm hoping to talk to Hypervolt today, but at the moment, it doesn't do the agile stuff, which I think is what you're getting at.
Yeah, well, at the moment, we've dropped down to 7.5p,
yeah.
so for me, I mean, my commute cost me about £2, and it's saving me approximately, I mean, I had a petrol car during when my MG ZS EV had a few problems, and it was cost me £15 a day to run in petrol, right? That means that across a year, I mean, I would basically, if I bought a Leaf for 4.5 grand even, I'd pay itself off in 3 years.
I did some sums recently, and I may have talked about this online. So the Nissan Leaf replaced a Honda HR-V, which was doing 36 miles a gallon on unleaded. The Leaf that's replaced that car was 11 times cheaper to run. 11 times.
11, wow.
Purely on fuel, and that's not even, I mean, obviously, if I was still running the Honda, I'd have to pay congestion charge because I work in London.
Yeah.
So purely on fuel, it's 11 times cheaper. If, you know, in the summer months, my Leaf was costing to run what the Honda was costing for an entire year.
As mentioned, you can definitely find Paul on the Nissan Leaf owners group. I will put everything, for example, the Twitter X or the YouTube channel, as well as the Facebook group. I've actually joined the Facebook group because they've been really, really supportive. They've told me all sorts about what I need to look out for
Leafs. They're lovely people there. They're lovely people.
Absolutely lovely people. And in fact, actually, you can catch Paul on there as well. So thank you very much, Paul.
Brilliant. Thanks a lot.
No worries at all.